Show of hands, who's excited for spring? I'm actually terrified because our winter was practically non-existent. So summer is going to be dreadful, I predict. But here we are, spring. Spring is on the horizon. So I'm actually thrilled because usually, I mean, you know, I'm a fall gal. That's my season to thrive. However, I surprised myself. I'm thrilled to say I actually have a lot of perfume recommendations to offer you this season. So much, in fact, I have two videos worth of recommendations. And the joy of a new fragrance rotation just temporarily settles my fears for the upcoming summer. No, it is a joy though. I love fragrance. I have a whole channel dedicated to it. So the first perfume I want to talk about is Xerjoff's Dama Bianca. This is truly spring in a bottle, and it has to be, without a shadow of a doubt, the most elegant fragrance in my collection. It's so elegant, it feels almost otherworldly, like an elven queen. Or if we are bringing it down to human level, Bridgerton's. This is most definitely giving Bridgerton era. So if you've been searching to capture the essence of a dainty, feminine, distinguished royal member of society, Dama Bianca is your girl. If she's human, she's a duchess. This is a beautiful, powdery, airy, light vanilla fragrance, and not vanilla that ever goes into a gourmand direction. It's not very sweet. It just has a very delicate, light amount of like this soft sweetness. So this could be a vanilla fragrance that perhaps normal vanilla haters might enjoy. It has this cloud of purple florals, a mix of violet, lilac, and iris. And sometimes purple florals can give off kind of like a vintage-like character. This to me smells absolutely timeless. Like it has this vibe to it where I can see it being a part of like the Bridgerton world, but make it modern. And then these florals are paired perfectly with these like pillowy, clean, fresh, musky notes. Personally, I just get the kumquat for the first several minutes, and then it goes into this feminine, powdery, dainty, vanilla, musky, purple floral blend. And I get about 6 hours moderate projection. If you're looking for a fun, girly, youthful fragrance that you can like easily wear every day, like a no fuss, just easy reach kind of perfume, I would recommend Paris Corner Qissa Pink. This is for people who love creamy, fruity, coconut, vanilla type perfumes. There's an apple note listed in here, and I do get this like juicy yet also a little bit crisp, you know, bright red apple, as well as a strawberry note, even though it's not listed. Like I get this kind of strawberries and cream feel. You have the coconut and the vanilla, so it's kind of giving me like a sweetened strawberry vanilla coconut milkshake kind of vibe, but make it perfumey. Like it's not a literal gourmand. It has some florals going on in the background to keep it from going too far into that territory. I specifically, out of the florals listed, only pick up the violet personally, and that adds a bit of a nice powderiness to the fragrance as well. But overall, I would describe this as a really creamy scent. So if you like those kind of perfumes, I would check this one out. And it's so affordable as well. I get about 5-6 hours out of this one with a moderate projection. You guys, I blind bought this and I love it. The Seven Virtues and I were like this. So at this point, like if I could just take a look at the notes and I'm like, looks good to me, I can pretty dang safely blind buy from the Seven Virtues. If you are a lover of your skin but better scents, put this on your to try list. If you are a lover of fragrances like Clean Reserve Skin, in the realm of that, you know how diehard obsessed I am with that one, put this on your to-try list. This is Amber Vanilla, by the way. I think there's something really special about this kind of category of perfumes, your skin a better scents, because there's just something undeniably attractive about them where you're not trying so hard. Like it's not, and don't get me wrong, I love those like bold, complex fragrances. I have plenty of them in my collection. Like that will always hold a special place in my heart. But so do these kind of perfumes, because when it's a profile that's not so bold or complex, but on your skin, it just blossoms. And people are like, is that you? Like, are you wearing a perfume? Is it like your hair products? Is it body products? Like, is it pheromones? What is going on? You're kind of bringing in this different type of allure. I feel like the name can be a little bit misleading, because from hearing amber vanilla, I would expect like a deep resinous fall winter type of scent. If it was ambroxan vanilla or vanilla musk, that would make more sense, but that'd be pretty boring of a name. Isoe super vanilla really rolls off the tongue, yeah? But amber vanilla, it's ambroxan vanilla, isoe super musk. That's the focal point of this fragrance. And the vanilla in here is not like super vanilla. Adds a nice soft kiss of sweetness, like this little touch of this inviting femininity, but it's really these musky components, this bit of a fresh, crisp, woody feel that I get the most. And interestingly, although sandalwood is not listed in the official note breakdown, on the actual bottle on the back here, it literally says it contains upcycled sweet santal. And I do pick up a sandalwood. And the way that pairs with the ambroxan isoe super is just There's a bit of carnation and pink pepper bringing in this like fresh, crisp, spicy element, which I think really pairs nicely with these musky molecules. So not only do I think it's great for people who like this kind of category of perfumes, but it's also a good fragrance for people who maybe don't typically enjoy fragrances, or they're susceptible to headaches often, or you need an inoffensive work fragrance, something of the sort. Very inviting scent. It's beautiful. I get about 4 hours with an intimate projection. Then from the House of Sillage, this crazy looking cupcake. It looks, as you could imagine, even more insane in person. Like, we got all these crystals, flowers, little bees on top. It's adorable. This was the first perfume that I fell in love with from House of Sillage. I remember when I discovered Baccarat Rouge 540, I was like on the hunt for every type of perfume that I could find that had like a vibe of that, but being its own perfume, like not too redundant, you know. And one of my subscribers, Lauren, sent me a sample of this. She's like, Anna, I seriously think you're gonna love House of Sillage Whispers of Truth. And I had not heard of it before this point. I smelled it and I was like, oh my gosh. Also, by the way, if you're not familiar with House of Sillage, they run sales all the time. Just wait. If there's a perfume you're eyeing, wait until there's a sale. So yes, I certainly got this on sale because it is a pricey one, but I do love it. This has a beautiful airy sweetness that just like comes alive even more in these warmer months. It's got like a big blast of citrus fruits, bergamot, orange, grapefruit. And by the way, this isn't too similar to BR540. And even if you don't like BR540, you could still enjoy this because they're certainly different enough. But you've got that like caramel and moss in the base that I feel like kind of mimics it a little bit. It's a very addictive, bright, fresh, citrusy kind of profile. And then it's also paired with some nice florals. Out of the florals, I get the rose. It's a very modern rose. And also, this is just a very likable profile overall. I do get a lot of compliments with this one. And I get a good performance out of this one. About 8 hours, moderate projection. Then we have Mind Games Castling. This is a very elegant, wealthy smelling scent. Very smooth, very chic. It's got a creamy sandalwood, powdery iris, and then there's a fig leaf in here, bringing in this like fresh green touch, but it also comes off coconutty to me. Like, fig and coconut are notes that can kind of like smell similar to each other at times. And because of that, I feel like I do get this kind of like chic, almost beachy experience from it, but not quite, not quite. It does absolutely scream spring to me rather than summer. Like, you can absolutely wear this in summer, but I'm just saying, if I were to put it in a category, that's why it's in this video. There's a little bit of sea salt and lotus. So I am getting this kind of aquatic vibe in the mix as well. I imagine this is the smell of a woman who comes from generational wealth, and she's like, I want to come out with my own brand, her own fashion line. She's very chic, very polished, and she's in the middle of working on a photo shoot near the beach. Not on the beach, near the beach. You kind of get like a little bit of that beachy vibe in the air, which is where I'm getting like, you know, kind of like the fresh, watery, aquatic, lotus, sea salt, coconutty fig, but it's just a little vibe of that. It's not like a full-on beach fragrance by any means. It's got a really nice musky presence, and the vanilla in here lends just a tiny natural dab of sweetness, just a little bit. A very upscale smelling perfume. Also, I don't know what it is, but men love the smell of this. I get compliments from men wearing this one. It's very pretty. And I get about 8 hours moderate projection. I've been so looking forward to the perfect season to wear Maissa L'Amour Eternal. I've worn it regardless, but spring is the season for L'Amour Eternal. This is a beautiful, just really fun, tropical, fruity blend of notes, like specifically orange fruits. It has apricot, nectarine, mango, peach. Out of all of the fruity notes, I definitely get mango the most. It's got a really nice, exotic, musky twist in the base from ambroxan and musk, and that remains like a prominent note in this fragrance, so you do have to be a lover of musk, I would say, to enjoy this. And musk can be done in so many different ways. This comes across like a very bright, sparkling, kind of like fizzy musk almost. And then it's sweetened a tad extra by a little bit of caramel and vanilla in the base. But I get most of the sweetness primarily just from those fruity notes, so that natural sweetness. It really just comes alive with the warmth of the season. It's so fun, bright, sparkling, and juicy. And I think if you perhaps are maybe bored with a lot of fruity perfumes and you're wanting something with like a little bit more pizzazz, try out this one. And I get about like 7 hours moderate projection. This is such a pretty girl perfume. I mean, it's literally parfum. Argos Parfum. If you enjoy your sweet fragrances, but you also want something that smells classy and put together, I would try out this one because this also has a mix of florals incorporated, but it's not a floral explosion in the way you might typically experience in like floral dominant perfumes. It's a very smooth, silky blend in here, and out of the florals, I get iris the most, giving it a little bit of that powdery feel. The other floral notes feel more like background dancers, if you will, except I can pick up the lavender in here. If you enjoy Flower Bomb by Victor and Ralph or Mongerlan, you will enjoy this perfume. It's definitely in that realm of fragrances. So the lavender will give it a little bit of an aromatic touch, but it's not too loud on the lavender. Like Mongerlan, for example, is certainly louder with that note. This has this nice fresh kick from citruses. There's just a little bit of ginger, pink pepper to bring in this classy spice, and then you have that sweetness coming through from tonka bean, vanilla. It's just overall a very likable perfume. Like, it's very crowd pleasing. It'll appeal to a lot of people. I think this would make a great gift, and I think most women who enjoy sweetened floral fragrances would like Parfum. Although I feel like this perfume suits spring the most, this could easily be someone's signature scent as well and worn year-round. And I get about 4 hours with moderate projection. And then the last one I'll go over for today, Rihanna Vanilla Tea. This is just like such a joyful perfume in my collection. Like, I spray this on and I'm instantly in a happy mood. It just has this comforting, playful, girly feel to it. It smells like you're wearing a flowy, floral printed, pretty dress, having a tea party with your girls. Specifically, apricot tea is being served in these dainty little, like, intricate designed teacups. You know, you got the little macaroons, little biscuits, a little bit of pear in there, a little bit of a pear essence. It's a perfectly bright, sunny day out, and then you go to scoop in your little sugar cubes. So you have the sweetness coming through from literally a sugar note as well as vanilla, and that brings in a little bit of a creaminess. This never goes too sweet though because of that like aromatic tea note cutting through. And it's tea done differently than I often experience in tea fragrances because usually they go in the direction of like citrusy, crisp, fresh. They head more into that aromatic territory. But if you're looking for tea with a little bit of sweetness, some fruit, some vanilla, I would check out Rihanna Vanilla Tea. I do pick up on this juicy blood orange and a little bit of like a background floral honeysuckle. So it's almost like at this tea party, you know, we got the blood orange trees and like honeysuckle in the surrounding area. It's lovely. Like certainly an easy reach, like no-brainer, just pretty perfume. I feel like this could be the scent of Alice from Alice in Wonderland, naturally. And I get about 6 hours moderate projection. So those are my recommendations for part one. I hope you enjoyed. Stay tuned for part two. Bye.